arena is ready for the continent's most spectacular series of races. Wins the German saloon car championships. Even on an international scale, it has the largest number of competitors and is the most popular top-class competition of its type. 10 years after the revolution of the quattro concept, the victory of an idea is being celebrated once again in an unfamiliar environment, under new conditions, before the most formidable adversaries. The creative tension which carries us forward must be based on revolution and tradition. Hans Stuck demonstrates the 1934 Auto Union racing car. And this long-staying power in sporting life presented Audi with 4 Rally World Championship titles, and later the victories in the American Trans Am and IMSA series. Two American racing years, there are new tasks awaiting Hans Stuck and Walter Ruhl, and they are by no means easy. The fully developed Audi V8 limousine enters the racing scene as a newcomer, in which the opposition is already solidly established. V8 is a good number, combined with and backed by the 420 HP, and those who have a stake in it are leading a competent crew, Herbert Kreiner and Hans Novak, Audi Sport's leading duo. Chief engineer Dieter Bascher and the racing stable's chief Konrad Schmidt. They all encounter the toughest competition from the most renowned houses, most of whom are already in the second evolutionary stage as symbolized by the mighty wings. With an eye to the normal driver, this motorsports competition will enhance its future products. And since Audi, BMW, Mercedes, and Opel, 4 of the world's top names, will be engaged in this contest, this must lead to a phenomenally high standard of competition with a rarely experienced atmospheric density. It is a very open and international bunch that meets here. Open for the young, who take on the old hands. Open to hopeful climbers against the establishment. To seeded champions against outsiders, which makes the German saloon car championships such a particular attraction. Surprises will not only be possible, but even desirable. There is no room for cementing old established hierarchies. Which does not mean to say that the most popular figure on the German racing scene should not take off with the usual clear instruction from its Bavarian fans. And all these well-shuffled cards will result in scenes full of musicality and ease of performance. Nürburg Ring is still the favorite place of pilgrimage for a wide, faithful flock of enthusiasts and connoisseurs. There is no question here of hasty thrills. Conversely, the experts will cultivate the build-up of emotions right to the closing moments of artistic enjoyment. This is a sort of practicing love, not only for the motoring sport, but also for this region, and for the ring which made it famous. And as a sign of admiration to this place of worship in motoring sport, we have recorded a rare and invaluable event. A qualifying lap in an hour when everything seemed to fit. The atmosphere, the light, the music and the Eiffel, and the dramatic search for the very last second. The Nürburg Ring and its master champion, Hans Stuck, in the Audi V8. Berlin, at a time as never before. The fifth and sixth races of the championships take place on the legendary Avis. And like the Nürburgring, the Avis 2 offers its very own image of the racing sport when the swarm of hornets inhales the long straight. The series of the German Saloon Car Championships consists of 11 racing days, each with two races. And because some lively variations are provided between permanent race courses, aerodrome races, and urban courses, some very varied demands are made on cars and drivers. One really ought to be a specialist. Best of all, a specialist in everything. All this is new ground for the young Audi team, who received a most cheerful welcome from the spectators, whose numbers are breaking all records in this year of top teams. Even during the opening races at Soldar and Hockenheim, Audi had cut a good figure, and now they're getting down to brass tacks. Double victories in Berlin and Wunstorf, there is great excitement about, and the greatest joy for one particular sportsman who is well known not only for his victories but also for the way in which he knows how to celebrate them. None other than Hans-Joachim Stuck wins as happily as he does. But is it possible that after a career spanning two decades of victories from Daytona to Le Mans, winning can still be such fun?
Oh, of course, because it's the sum total of consistency, strategy and diligence. And if I didn't have such a lot of fun and motivation, I just wouldn't be racing. And as much pleasure as I get out of it, I can become very angry at times. And if I don't have all the pleasure, the motivation and joy anymore, then I'd rather stay at home.
Almost home. This is Nuremberg. ...90,000 spectators, the record of the year, follow the call to the Bavarian Grand Prix on the Norris Ring. Amongst them, 3,000 enthusiastic Audi employees. Until now, Stuck was the only one to collect Audi points. And in the meantime, a congenial partner had concentrated in the background on development work. Now, withdrew, the immensely popular former Rally World Champion, enters the action. This will make the Audi appearances of the championship even more attractive. And the two old friends who get along so well, notwithstanding their different nature, enhance the image of a racing series with all the refinements of teamwork that needs no sophisticated prior consultations or maneuvers, but which evolves as if it were the most natural thing in the world. Ruhl basically sees his role in the championship as that of a faithful lieutenant for Stuck with his superb lead on points. the rivals react to the new front that resulted from Audi's strong performances. BMW has engaged the previous year's DTM champion, the Italian Robert Ravaglia, who promptly won one of the two Nürburgring races. The other was carried off by Hans-Joachim, who thus quite sensationally takes over the championship lead. However, the consequence of this victory and of the championship lead is a weight handicap awarded to Audi by the sporting authorities. Stuck comments, it's as if they put a giant cauldron of hot sausages in the car. Balancing superiority by waiting is an American custom, so as to keep up the suspense of the racing series throughout the year. Meanwhile, it has also become part of the rules of the game of the German saloon car championships, and every team affected by them must learn to live with them. For the leading teams, this means the beginning of a new development phase, a dialogue between technicians and practitioners. Once again, Audi Sport goes through the subtle phases of exploring outer limits in search for better performance, optimum handling, and a new harmony in a car which weighs 80 kilograms more than it would normally. These are the lean weeks of this summer. Only one single point in four races. Walter Ruhl's victory on the Nürburgring can be seen at any rate as a turning point in the trend, and as far as the figures go, a symbol for a still existing chance of an overall victory. And this decision, the highlight and finale of the racing series, will be made on the Hockenheim Ring. For this quite extraordinary occasion, which gets 70,000 fans on their feet, each team will regroup once again, engaging guest drivers in order to apply more effectively any stable strategy. Four drivers, three makes, make the journey with the chance of the championship title. Apart from Stuck and Ruhl, Audi has engaged Frank Jelinski as a reinforcement. They make the match. Hans-Joachim Stuck, the leader, Johnny Cecotto in a BMW, Kurt Thiem in a Mercedes, and Steve Soper in a BMW. And so we immerse ourselves into thrilling tension, which a happy production managed to reserve for the very last racing day of a long and exciting series. The fabulous crowd of spectators is part of this atmosphere, which could nowhere reach greater heights than at the Hockenheim Motordrome. Once again, the clash of BMW, Mercedes, Opel and Audi with the best drivers they could get. Once again, the polarization on a technical level too. The quattro four-wheel concept against the conventional drives. It is good to know that the man who fights out there with the team for the championship is called Hans Stuck. And it is a cheering thought to know that there is a Walter Ruhl as a backup, as well as the tremendously strong driver, Jelensky. And so a day emerges, which those 70,000 people at the Hockenheim Ring will not forget in a hurry. Least of all us. We get the most spectacular result one could possibly conceive. Audi runs in both races with its three cars in positions 1, 2, 3. Each time, Stuck as the winner, flanked by his friends. The motordrome goes wild with excitement. Audi V8, the German champion. What an outsider tip for the start of the championship. Stands for the car they did not manage to leave behind. Quattro, again and again, stands for the victory of an idea. And Hans Stuck is our champion.